see. I think I can safely say that the referee for this gold medal match is Dila Turdikulova of Uzbekistan. Rule number two. Top rule number 12. Hungarian likes to keep his arm out, and he's very effective at doing that. Di Veroli a little more fluid. Hungarian's quite tall. And it's definitely got good arm strength. But not fast enough that time. He launches flesh attack. Di Veroli just keeps backing up. And hits with a counter. Well, Mata Tamas Koch just can't find a way through. And it is that fluidity. Picking up the blade, turning and getting the riposte. Holds off that flesh attack. But he cannot find a way through the defense of Di Veroli. Really using distance management really, really well. Drawing the attack. Well, pinned to the back line makes things a little easier for the Hungarian. But that's his first hit in this gold medal match. Thank you. Well, he's found a way to hit him, but I think it starts with pressing him down towards the end of the piece. We go to our first 1 minute break. Dominant from Davide Di Veroli. The Hungarian is going to have to change something. Great to have a crowd like this. It's also great to be able to hear yourself. Okay, second period. Here we go. Brilliant. Brilliant, perfectly timed flash attack from Di Veroli. He's playing the defense very well, but when he unleashes his offensive side, he's deadly. So Koch has changed something in particular, and that is he's attacking from a better distance. And there, catching Di Veroli on his counter. Keeping the distance closer. And twice now, he's gone for the weapon arm of the left-hander, Di Veroli. He tried it again. But Di Veroli with some body evasion there. Duck. Allowed his counterattack to go through. Well, Koch's attack just sailed over his shoulder. Seeing more speed and precision from the Hungarian, but still in his own style.
Finale.
Now let's see, Veroli, who's pressing now. And has not to Tamas Koch on the warning track. Then takes the blade and flicks across the front. We know from the first semifinal that Di Veroli doesn't think the period has ended until it has. So much better from the Hungarian. Wasn't that Di Veroli let up on anything. It's just that Monte Tamas Koch was using distance better, using it more strategically, and more likely to get a result, which it did. Here we go, third and final period, this for the gold. Yeah, that's... Dr. Tamas Koch signaled, I did not hit his foot. I could see that from up here. Said, no, that was not a hit. Sportsmanship is still alive. Searching, looking for the opportunity. And he's got the Hungarian on the back line. Okay, so she has asked the floor judges to be on the lookout for something. Again, she stopped the match. For very good reason. Passivity. So, passivity card showed to both. Not to Tamas Koch, got the parry, couldn't get it riposte. Oh, but he got the hit to the foot. Yep. That one sticks. But they're going to look at it. We'll get to see it. But on our slow-mo replay, it's very clear. There we see it. Looked like it glanced off the side of his foot over the arch. Yeah. So Hungarian in the lead. Minute 14 remaining in this gold medal match. Really pressing again. Oh. He got Monte Tamas Koch on the back line and then got hit with a counterattack. And now he's pressing. And that's a very dangerous and very vulnerable place to be in. When you're chasing points with the clock winding down, your opponent knows exactly what you're doing and has, in many cases, a counterattack waiting for you. Di Veroli keeps working at that one. Gets it through. Still a world of time. This is why Monte Tamas Koch keeps his arm out all the time. Di Veroli grits one back. Well, the Hungarian is already on a yellow card, a proper yellow card, and now is Davide Di Veroli. Oh, parry riposte on the back line. 6.92 seconds remaining in this gold medal match. And we know that Di Veroli can do it. 4.52 seconds. Well, Gabor Bochco wants that hit annulled. Three, his weapon got stuck in the strap. Three point 14 seconds. And a gold medal is going home to Hungary. And he might even have time to do it on score instead of time. And that will do it. We've got a new men's épée world champion, Maxi Tamas Koch of Hungary. Our 2023 men's épée world champion. It's a silver medal for Davide Di Veroli. But he's 21 years old. You know he'll be back. He'll be back in a gold medal match again. Tonight, Italy takes home one gold, two silver, and one bronze. And that's on day two. Great match. The Hungarians started so slowly. That it was really hard to see how he could turn it around, but he did. He changed what he needed to change. And when somebody like Gabor Bochco is your coach, you know you've got a secret weapon. It's not really a secret.